Hi, and welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. Today I'm very excited, because today I finally can assemble my second U-Gears model. The first one was the mechanical box that I assembled some weeks ago, which was pretty cool. And today I have another model here, which is much more challenging, I expect, because it has much more parts as the first one, and this is called the Safe, also made by U-Gears. According to the box, it's written down here that it's a safe with a 3-digit mechanical lock. So I'm not sure if I can set the number later or how this works. I have no idea how this should work, but it will be very interesting for sure. Okay, so the parts are out of the box, and we can see we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 single wooden sheets here that are laser cut, of course. And as we saw in the last episode, we can just break these parts out. You will see later in the video how this works. There's also a manual coming with it again, and here it's described in very detail how to assemble the wooden safe step by step. So I will go now through it. Of course, I will put some parts where I do the assembly process in time lapse with some music for you to enjoy it. And I'm really excited to see how this thing might look like when we start. Okay, let's just go to the beginning, to step number one. Guys, I tell you, the housing is done, and I had really a hard time here to push all these things in. My fingers are really hurting, but anyway, I can recommend it to you. Do it by hand. If you do not do it by hand, I just use this pinch here to push in some of those. And if you use an additional tool, you have a high risk to break some parts. So also happened to me. I broke some of the small parts, but this is not the fault of the manufacturer. This is my own fault because I used an additional tool. Use your fingers and you can be sure the force you will push these in is not too high. Also, you should stick exactly, and I mean really exactly, to the instruction, because if you do not, as I did, obviously, you have to do everything twice, because you assemble a part in the wrong orientation and so on, and then you have to get it out again, reassemble it, and this has also, or includes also, a high risk of damaging part. Anyway, I finally finished here the housing, I think. I hope it's finished now, or nearly finished, and now I will continue here with this one. I need to wax it, and this is very important because some of these mechanism parts are doing some relative movement to each other. Therefore, if there is mentioned to wax it, do it, otherwise the mechanism might not work properly. Okay, so I wax the complete surface as described. And now I'm gonna stack up here these parts, also part of the mechanism, together. Mm-hmm. Works. Okay, so this is the finalized part here of this mechanism, and since it is waxed, you can see it's running pretty smooth, even if it's only wood. And I'm still curious what this is for, but I'm sure we will find out when I continue. Okay, so this is the front door mechanism, I don't know. And we have four toothsticks that need to get in here now. And number four. Now I'm gonna continue with the assembly of these four pinions. They are all the same, so I can just put them just in here. I will assemble them. I think it's also again symmetric, so it doesn't matter how I put them in. And here we have it, our planetary gear. Very cool. And now it's time for these two rubber bands. So we'll just put them through here and then attach them over here. Yeah. Oh yeah, and it provides you a lot of force to making this mechanism snap into here and lock it. If I did everything right and it fits, or if I made a mistake and then I'm really fucked up here. Here we go, the safe is done. Boah, I think it took me really about 4 hours to build this thing, and it's quite heavy. So it looks just amazing if you ask me, just amazing. And if you build it yourself, it's even cooler. There's even in the compartment, there's even two separated places where you can put your things. And it just open and close it. Close quite nice. Sounds a little bit vintage here. Even I've used a lot of wax. But you can see also here how small these gaps are between these parts here. The parts that are moved, you can see there's nearly no gap between here. So pretty cool. And an excellent job designing this by U Gears. And now let's see if it works. So, because this is something I do not know. And let's just have a look. I will just scramble it up. And the combination should be 3-2-1 according to the manual. But you can also set, of course, a different combination. And now I'm excited to see if it works or not. So the safe is locked now. Cannot open it up. And according to the manual, you need to rotate counterclockwise until the first number. Yeah, I hear something like a snapping noise or something. Then you rotate to the zero, and then you rotate clockwise until you reach the second number of your code. And this is here number 2 in my case. Okay, not sure if I heard something. And then you rotate counterclockwise again until you reach number 1. And if I reach number 1, this thing here should snap open. Yep, it works. Pretty cool. And now I can just use it here and open up the safe. So it really works. It's an amazing thing, and you can have quite a lot of fun. Do you see my how red my hands are? This is from just pushing here these things in and pulling them out. And as I already said previously, stick to the manual, otherwise you have to do a lot of things twice. So happened to me, and it's amazing. I'm not sure what I will do with this thing, but this will get a very cool place here in my flat. If you also tried one of these puzzles yourself and have also a favorite here of the U-Gears models, just let me know in the comments. I will check these also for sure. Maybe I will also do another episode of those. And if you like this episode as much as I did, just leave a like below this video. Comment below if you just would like to leave a comment about this video or my channel or what I could improve in further episodes. And of course, you can also subscribe to my Instagram and Facebook channels. And until next time, keep on puzzling!